Greetings from Chip Theory Games. My name is Adam Carlson. Thank you for joining me today. Here I have our game, Too Many Barons. The setup right now is for our final battle. I've played Patches and Tantrum all the way up to now. We are now on day 8. On our day counter, I have acquired enough progress points. 6 progress points are required to approach Drellen within 10 days. I've got a couple of extra days if I want to spend them and continue with the more encounters to try and get more skill points, stat points, maybe some loot. But I feel like that I'm ready, and I think that I want to give it a chance. If I am unsuccessful today facing Drellen, I can take another day and try and recover from that and approach Drellen once again, as long as it's day 10 or earlier. So this will give me kind of a second chance, if you will. So here we've got Drellen Paleface, our tyrant for the day. These are the 3 baddie types that he's got, the bogs, the orcs, and the beasts. I'm sorry, the bogs, the goblins, and the beasts. On the back side, let's just read about this here. Ages ago, Drellen was banished from Obendar to the Poison Marshes for reasons no one can or is willing to recall. Instead of perishing, however, Drellen remains alive. Face twisted and scarred from extended time in the swamps, he is but skin and bones, yet somehow he thrives in the bog. All right, so the Battle of the Bog is the back side of the card. So when I'm ready to approach him, I'll just flip this card over and follow the instructions. Place Drellen in lane 1. Draw bog type baddies and place in lanes 2 and 3. For parties 1 to 2, place 2 1-point bog type baddies. So I've got, I'm a party of 2. I've got Tantrum and Patches. So here's Drellen's chip. I get him out and I put him in lane 1. And I find 2 bog type baddies. So these are the level 1 baddies that are still remaining. I have here my defeated pile, but I will try and find bog type baddies in this pile first, starting with the top. First one is Bog Pole. He will go in lane 2. He is a bog type baddie, as shown on the bottom right hand corner of this chip. That symbol there is bogs. Next chip is, it happens to be another bog type. We've got the Clay Golem. So even though the Golem is not a bog, it's a bog type. So he qualifies. So he will go in lane 3, just like that. The battle is set so far. So let me just get these guys lined up here. Drellen has initiative of 5. I'm just going to put him up close so you can see all about who Drellen is. 8 health, 5 initiative, 3 attack, 2 defense. That symbol next to the defense is a tyrant die. So he'll be rolling that each time it's his turn. Looks like it's a melee type, and he attacks the 2 weakest opposing units. So he only moves once, but if there are 2 opposing units, if both Tantrum and Patches are adjacent to him when he attacks, we both get hit. So we might want to try and avoid that situation from happening, if at all possible. I'm putting the lane marker down, and here is Drellen up front, melee type baddie. The Bog Pole is ranged. He goes in the back. There he is. Clay Golem, 5 health. He's melee, so up front. I'm putting down the initiatives. So Clay Golem has a 2 initiative, Drellen has 5, and the Bog Pole has a 3. So the dice will go in the initiative meter in descending order. All right, I'm gonna finish reading the card, finish the instructions here. Says BQ, baddie points. party of one ignores this. So there is a battle queue of baddie points. So I am on day 8. Two in my party. So I'm multiplying 8 by 2 is 16. 16 baddie points. So I've got 3 level 5s, followed by a level 1 on the bottom of the BQ. So this is 16 points. And this is all in addition to Drellen and his 2 bogs. So it might seem rather impossible at the moment, but we'll see how it goes. I put those there. I need to fill the 4th lane with the top baddie, which happens to be a 5. All right, Griffin Howler, 5 health. He goes up front. So here's the Griffin Howler. He has dive, flight, signal 1. Pretty intense baddie. All right, here we go. I need a sip of my coffee here for this one. All right, so Drellen will have his poison die. I'm just gonna set it there for now. Reading on in this card, each moved position in this battle requires 2 decks instead of 1. His Tyrant skills, Bog Ruler, as long as there are any Bog-type baddies on the battle mat, Drellen cannot lose HP. Poison has no effect on Drellen. His Tyrant die has 2 different symbols on it. A Poison Enhancer, so if there's a Poison on the gear lock, it will be maxed at 3. Or simply a Poison 2 will be applied to any and all gear locks adjacent to him. In this case, so I'm going to put this card back up there as a reminder for me. Again, I was able to heal up Tantrum and Patches prior to this day, so I'm pretty well decked out here. I've got a couple of useful pieces of loot. We have a roll, 2 additional attack dice, and a mixed berries for Tantrum. Those are pretty useful. Looks like Tantrum has 3 health stat die on top of his 4, so he's pretty healthy. Patches as well is pretty healthy. Patches loot includes Zelfie seeds and utility parts. So healing any gear lock for 2 or unexhaust 1 die. All of these can be useful in this fight. I just have to keep an eye on them. All right, so the next thing that happens is we roll initiative for the gear locks and figure out when we go. Tantrum rolled a 5. I'm going to put him on top. Patches has a 3. He goes right in the middle. Right in the middle of the pack. So this is good. This is good. Now the gear locks come out on the mat. They're both melee type. So they both will go in the front row of the gear lock side of the battle mat. I need to make a plan here. I think my plan, the Howler is kind of a tough one, but I don't want to focus on the Howler just yet. I'm thinking I want to take out the bogs first, and then see if I can open up a spot for Drellen. Open up an opportunity for me to attack Drellen if there are no bogs coming. So I think that'll be my plan. Let's see here. I just wanted to move that over there. Patches. Let's have Patches. Let's see, the plan is I need to figure out when Drellen goes and what his first move is. He's going to pursue the closest, weakest, and start poisoning right away. Let's put Patches over here. Maybe I can drop a poison on the clay golem. I think that will help. I think that's a good play. Let's do that. Okay, moving on. Tantrum's up. So, Tantrum has dexterity 3 plus 1, 4 dex, which gives me 4 dice to roll. Obviously, the reason why I placed that there is I would like to step up. First play, to hit the bog pole. Now, in doing so, it cost me 2 dex to move. So now I'm already down to 2 total dex to play. This Rage 1.0 die starts up there at the start of the fight, which I just did. So now it's in the active slot. So I'll be keeping an eye on that, trying to build up my Rage as we play. So I have 2 dex left. I have Cripple for Drellen. I want to be able to apply this onto Drellen to kind of reduce his attack. I think that would help. I could also do maybe a disable for the Howler, which will prevent dive, flight, signal one. Not very useful. Maybe I'll save the disable. And I realized I have 2 axes that I carried in from the last fight. Intimidate. That's a good play to drop on Drellen. So let's do Intimidate. Okay. Now, my target is actually going to be Drellen. The rules on the card say Drellen cannot lose HP as long as there is bogs in play. But I certainly can choose Drellen as my target and modify him in other ways to try and mitigate the damage. So, with the remaining 2 decks, these are my options. I'm going after Drellen. Looks like I missed on the initiative modifier. That's the bones. I don't have to take that. I'm going to put the 9 right back in there and save it for another round. I did, however, hit with the -1 attack stat. So that will go up there. I'm just going to remove this die. So, Drellen has now 1 less attack. He's down to 2 attack instead of 3 for his stat. So that should help. That's my play. Just like that, I'm already done. Crazy. I go up to 1.2 in Rage because I attacked Drellen, even though I did not get a chance to roll an attack die. I did not get a chance to damage him himself. So I'm at 1.2. Next up is Drellen. So Drellen will be pursuing the closest, weakest gear lock. Tantrum is the closest as he is adjacent to Drellen. So Drellen will go ahead and make his play. He's got his Tyrant die. 3 attack dice has now been modified to 2, and now 2 defense as well. Here it is. That's actually a pretty good roll for me. This symbol here multiplies any poison counter that I have on me, which is none at the moment. I will in a second, but this has no effect. So I'll put that back. So 2 damage. The defense will go on Drellen. His bones does nothing. So 2 damage I took. 1-2 off of Tantrum. All right, and I will be going up with my Rage 1-2 ticks. I'm now at 1.6. My magic number is 1.8 so that I can upgrade to my Tier 2 Rage die. Next up is the Griffin Howler. Griffin Howler has 3 attacked ice. He pursues the closest weakest gladiator, opposing unit, so that would be Tantrum. So he doesn't move. He's gonna roar. Ouch! Ouch! He does five damage. That was an incredible roar. Incredible roar. That's enough to knock me out. There I go, just like that. All right, and the howler now has flight from his flight skill that he's got. So now he's untargetable for one round. Now because I've been knocked out, my rage die will reset, well, it will go back, yes. So my active, my locked, and my bones are erased. The rage die actually was used since it was in the active slot. So rage 1.0 is exhausted, just like that. I was unable to take advantage of it. Just double checking. I've got mixed berries here. Now we've got a rule book here. If you want to find out when some of these loot options are able to be used, I'm just double checking here. I've got my loot section on page 16. I'm limited to 4 loot. I've got that. Just scrolling down here. During battle, if not specified otherwise, loot and trove loot must be used on your turn. So this says heal for 3 HP in battle or 5 HP out of battle. So unfortunately, that's one of the ones that I have to use on my turn. I'm unable to do that reactively. There may be a loot or a heal that you're able to use in that instant to stay alive, but not this one. All right. So I come off the initiative meter. Next up, Patches. Patches. Okay, Patches has options. First of all, I want to get Tantrum back into play. Patches has liquid life. That's the key for me. So I need to do liquid life on Tantrum to get him back in. I want to do it now. Other options. I can do a poison for the golem. And I might want to do, let me throw up some defense, because it's going to hurt if I don't get some defense up. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm okay with the setup currently. Yeah, that'll be fine. Let's do that. Okay, so with Patches, 4 dexterity. These are the 4 that I've chosen to roll. Here we go. We've got a revive for Tantrum at 2 HP. I want to do that. So what I'm doing here is, in fact, for this die, I'm exhausting it, and we get to put 2 HP under Tantrum immediately, and he's ready to go up on the battle mat. The initiative die will be placed up there to show that he's ready to step in at the end of the round. And Tantrum's chips are not on the battle mat until after this round is over. For the rest of our options, we've got 1 defense, 1 bones. I've got another 2 bones here, which is essentially a miss for one of my poison. I'm not going to use it. I'm going to save it. All right. Perfect. Passage is done. Next up is purple. That's the bog frog. Since it's a ranged baddie, it does not move. It just attacks. The 2 weakest opposing units, there's only 1 in play right now, and that's Patches. It doesn't have any attack dice. It simply applies a poison. Right on him. He's done. Next up is the clay golem. The clay golem has break, along with one attack die. He misses. That's lucky for me. So nothing happens. The break skill is, and I've got my Gearlock Adventuring Reference Guide right here. This is the backside. It's a list of all the baddie skills and encounter terms. If you read here, break, any attack dice used to reduce this unit's HP must be exhausted. So I don't exactly want to just start rolling my attack dice against that clay golem. That's why I chose to go for the poison. So that round is over. We're on the end of the round, so Tantrum will go back into the battle mat. Now Gearlocks, Tyrants, and level 20 baddies, when they enter the battle mat after round one, they go to the top. Any level 1 or level 5 baddies, when they come in after round 1, they go straight to the bottom. So Tantrum comes in at the top. He's got his 2 HP. Which isn't very good. And he has to go in one of these three starting positions for Tantrum. Trying to figure out what I want to do here with Tantrum once I bring him out. I can't attack him. He's untargetable. Drellen cannot be damaged at this point. We have the Bog Pole, but he's two spots away from me. I'm not feeling very encouraged by the setup currently. Let's go there. I have a plan, trust me. I'm thinking, well, maybe let's go there. All right, I want to jump. This is Tantrum's one skill that will allow me to actually jump to any open position on the battle mat just using the skill. So that's super efficient against Drellen. Intimidate. Yes, I still want to intimidate Drellen. I still have two decks left. I have a mixed berries. I heal myself for 3 in battle. I'm definitely doing that now. So discard that for my 3 HP. I knew I had a way of getting HP. That was it. So I'm up to 5 now. That doesn't cost me a dex. It's just one of my options there for loot. Disable, I'm saving that. I could roll it against the break. That would be smart. And then I don't have any defense dice, attack dice. Let's do one attack die. Okay? So my 4 decks. That's my choices. Let's see what happens here. Ouch! Not exactly what I was hoping for. I've got my jump, my attack, and 2 misses. The misses are going back on the battle mat. I need to use those later. I've got my attack. I'm going to attack Drellen and hit that 1 defense off just because I can. It doesn't really affect too much. He can still roll that on his next turn, but might as well. As long as he's not losing HP, I can still whittle away on his defense. The jump skill. Let me just refer to Tantrum's reference sheet here. Jump. Select any baddie before or after attacking and place yourself adjacent to it. All right, I've already attacked. I'm selecting the clay golem. And I'm literally jumping over there. I think that position is good for me. I realize that Drellen's going to come after me, but I don't think I have much of a choice Otherwise, I need to try and survive that one play. We'll see what happens. Okay? And next up is Drellen. Drellen will pursue the closest, weakest. The closest, weakest. That's me. That's Tantrum. And because I have one fewer HP than Patches did. Drellen will roll all of his dice. Now that modification, that minus one attack die, is for the entire battle. So he had what we would consider pretty much a perfect roll. 2-4 damage and 2-4 defense. The poison, however, he did not land, but no matter. It hurt me bad enough. 1, 2, 3, 4. I've got 1 HP left. 1 HP. So that really hurt. Alright, that goes there. Next up is the Howler. The Howler will pursue the closest, weakest. Tantrum, even though he's just as far away as Patches is, there's no available position to pursue me. So he goes to the only target he can attempt to reach. My options are 1, 2. Or 1-2. I think at this point, I think that would be okay. Now, because he had flight, I'm looking up a skill. He's also got dive. Some of the griffins don't have dive. This one has dive. If the flight effect die is active on this unit at the start of its turn, immediately place this unit adjacent to the weakest available opposing unit and target it. So he immediately is picked up and placed adjacent to the weakest available. There's only one. That's Patches. And he targets it. Also, I don't know if I did my signal one. Let me just see here. Signal one is what, I'm bringing out my terms again. Add to the bottom of BQ one additional baddie, one level below this baddie. Skill occurs number of times, once per round. So signal one essentially allows him to bring out a level one baddie, right on the bottom. Level one baddie right on the bottom. He's been added. All right. And he attacks. 3 attack dice, 2 Patches. Only a hit for one. Patches is kind of lucky. Tantrum's not doing too hot right now at this point. Patches is up. So the poison kicks in. And then Patches has innate recovery, which is a regen once per round. Last round he was not hurt. This round he is. So he just lost one, gained one. He's still down to 6 health at this point. Let's see, we've got 4 dexterity. Tantrum looks like he's about ready to, I don't know, he's going to get hurt if I don't do something. Poison dart, maybe I'll use utility parts and unexhaust the liquid life again. Discard that. I've got Zelfie seeds, heal any gear lock for 2 HP. I'm going to go ahead and do that on Tantrum right now. Might not be much, but it will help. It will help. So let's do some poison on some of these guys. He won't be able to apply poison here, but we need to try and get rid of the bars as fast as we can. I just realized when the howler hit me, I should have removed the defense die rather than a chip. It's important to remember that as you play, it does matter. Because now I have an additional defense die to roll this turn, and you don't have that choice. You have to take defense away from here first before you can take away HP from that, because you don't, yeah. Let's see, a buff. Let's lay down a buff on Tantrum. One more dexterity. Chem kit. Four, five, six, seven. Chem kit. Okay. Those are my four options here. We've got a poison two, a buff for five. I'm gonna place that on Tantrum. So Tantrum gets five HP. Place right on his prep area. Poison two to adjacent. Actually target, I think. So yes, on your target, which was the clay golem. And then the dart goes to anybody. I want to put the dart on the frog and work on him a little bit. And then I missed on my chem kit. So that goes back there because I want to save it for later. All right, so Patches is kind of vulnerable without any defense. We'll see how it goes. Tantrum's all of a sudden a little healthy. That's good. Alright, next up, Bog Frog takes two poison damage. One, two. And this down ticks to one. You can even use the actual poison counter if that would be easier and exhaust that. That might be easier to read. Sometimes we are able to use the poison die, the actual item itself. So he stays put. He attacks both of us with a poison die. So just like that, Tantrum, Patches, or each poison for one. He's done. Next up is the clay golem. He attacks the strongest, the closest strongest. Clay golem takes two poison damage, and this down ticks to one. He attacks Patches for one. Ouch! Hits for two. Patches is getting hurt. For an update, Patches has five health and one poison on him. He won't be able to take too much more damage. Yeah. And that round is over. Round three. First up is Tantrum. Tantrum, Tantrum, Tantrum. The rage, the anger management. Unfortunately, I lost that. So I'm not working on that. I've got Intimidate. I can still try and drop down Drellen. Way of the Wild. Is it disable? Maybe I'll do that. I have Axe Collector. Now, I'm going to definitely be using that. Interesting. Okay, Tantrum. Here's his decisions. We're going to, Intimidate only applies to target. So he won't be able to put that on Drellen if he attacks the clay golem. So I want to disable the clay golem and I want to hit it without exhausting my dice. We'll see how that goes. And Tantrum to the clay golem. So we have hit with to disable, and I'm going to use it. I've got two bones on my way to Axe Collector or Recoup. I've got my one that I just took away from him, and his break is disabled, so I don't exhaust my attack die. I still have it available. I'm thinking out loud here if I want to use my X Collector. I'm just going to refer to the sheet again. Deal 2 damage to non-adjacent baddie once per turn. Each time you use X Collector, reduce this die by 1. On the back side, we have another paragraph on X Collector. X Collector is used to do 2 damage, usable once per turn. The Fortunate Discovery is, well, the Axe Collector on the backup plan grants me an additional 3. It's never exhausted. So a non-adjacent, I could throw an axe on the bog pole, but he will take care of himself. He's got a poison. I don't need to waste on that. These two are adjacent, so they're not options. I don't mind the Howler. I'm going to leave him be. So, my turn is over. Okay, next up is Drellen. And by the way, I did not take my poison damage on my turn. My bad. So poison takes 2 damage. It does 2 damage to Tantrum. I cannot take my poison damage from my buff HP. There's HP and there's buff HP. There's a distinct difference between the two. When you're applied true damage, it takes straight out of your gear lock. And all of that is covered under here as well. We've got under poison, reset a poison effect die on your target for number. Target takes true damage equal to the effect number. Perfect. Drellen's up. Both of Drellen's defense are up, so all he rolls are his 2 attack dice and his Tyrant die on me. I've already taken my poison damage, so that comes off. Here's Drellen's roll. 2 damage, and I maximized the poison. Fortunately, just before he went, my poison die went away, so this has no effect. This turn, 2 damage. Now that is not true damage. I can take that right out of my buff HP. So I'm still sitting okay. That's good, that's good. All right. Drellen is done, just like that. Starting to feel like I can maybe do this. Green is up. That's the Howler again. The Howler will stay next to the closest, weakest, that's Patches. Howler rolls 3 attack dice. Ouch! For 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Patches now just has 1 HP left. 1 HP left. That's not good. And the Howler is now untargetable. He gains flight. All right, next up is Patches. Now, in a stroke of luck, Patches actually has the innate recovery. He will take his poison damage, and he will regen. Those are both instances that occur at the start of Patches' turn. So anything that happens at the start of Patches' turn, you take care of all of those things at once. So he was able to fortunately survive that with 1 HP. It's time. It's time for Patches to roll some stuff. Okay, we've got a heal, a buff, a liquid life. I'm gonna put that on Tantrum. A chem kit. definitely want to put that on Tantrum. But, I really, really, really want to attack the clay golem and hit it for one. So I'm throwing that in there. I'll explain why very, very soon. Here's hoping. I hit with everything. Yes! Okay. So, the chem kit to attack. I'm applying that on Tantrum. If you see on Patch's sheet right here, we find that symbol. It's a buff attack. It goes on ally or active ally. That's the AA, an ally active slot. So add number to a Gearlock's attack stat last entire battle. I'm definitely giving that to Tantrum. I want to boost him up as much as I can to give him a chance to finish this thing for us. We've got also our Liquid Life. I'm putting that on Tantrum as well. A heal, interesting. An attack, I'm hitting the Clay Golem. So I can resolve that first. I've got a heal. Do I want to heal Patches? He still has a heal and a buff. Maybe I do want to keep Patches alive just a little bit longer. Yes, I'm going to heal Patches. So this is exhausted. Patches gets 3 HP. Up to 4 now. That's a close call. All right, next up is the Bog Paw. Bog Paw loses its one remaining HP from the poison. Just like that, our first defeated baddie of this fight. Now we've got lots more baddies that are ready to come out. So that comes out. Next up is the Clay Golem. Incidentally, he has a poison. He loses his only remaining HP. So he is defeated as well. So I kind of timed that just right. So if you were paying attention, the two units that fell are actually Bog type baddies. And I'm crossing my fingers, hoping that maybe just one or maybe none of the next two baddies that come out are Bog type. If you recall on the sheet for Drellen, on this card, it says under Tyrant skills, Bog Ruler, if any Bog type baddies are on the battle map, Drellen cannot lose HP. Poison has no effect on Drellen. Okay, so if there are no Bog-type baddies that come out next, then Drellen is vulnerable for damage at that point. Okay, end of the round, and the baddies come out. First one comes out in, let's see, lane one is taken. So the first one comes out in lane two, so he will get the purple lane assignment. It is a Goblin Sapper. Melee. 5 attack. Ouch! I'm sorry, 5 health. 3 attack. 2 mischief. That sapper would essentially take out all or most of my active slot stuff, which I don't want him to remove. Really, really, really bad. Because it's a level 1 or level 5 baddie, he goes right to the bottom. Next baddie comes out. It's yes, let me just double check something. I've taken out 2 ones. So yeah, 3 5s. So that's 1 5, that's another 5. This is the third 5 because I added 16 baddie points to this. So here's the third 5, this Goblin Alarmist, and then there's the 16th point. And then that bottom was from the signal one. So it's correct. Here we go. 6 health. Now he gets the yellow assignment. But I'm standing in his spot. So now he checks ranged position 1 and then ranged position 2. So he, if the spot that is supposed to belong is taken, it starts at 1, 2, 3, 4 again. to check for availability. The alarmist will go there. And he has signal 3. He brings in more baddies. However, I just noticed some very good news. There are no bog type baddies on the mat at this point. So, Drellen's the only one, and that's the exception, of course. So, this is going to be fun. Alarmist goes on the bottom. We are now in round 4. Top of round 4. Tantrum's up. Tantrum is up. Tantrum's got some options. I'm looking at what I've got here. I've got 5 health. These guys are going to hit me. 2, 5, 6. I'm planning on getting 6 damage this round. So I need to figure out how to get 2 more HP or do something else about that. I might need patches to step up and block something for me. But this guy goes, and he will block. I might be in trouble here. So I think I'm gonna get KO'd this round. And if I am, that's okay. It's part of it. Going over my options again. There doesn't seem to be much for options. I'm gonna try and take as big a hit out of Drellen as I can right now. Okay? So this will be fun, actually. I need to dig out some more attack dice. But the game comes with 12. I might need all 12. Let's do some math here. Okay, so Tantrum has 4 dex, he has 4 attack. So I'm getting out this, I've got 1, 2, 3, 4 attack. He also has his, the attack buff. You know what? Add to Gearlock's attack stat. So, unfortunately, I misunderstood that one. You always go back to the definitions to figure out what exactly they do. I was thinking I got 2 extra dice, but I was mistaken. I do have Infused Incense, plus 2 additional attack dice on my turn. It's a single use. So I'm going to go ahead and spend that and add 2 more. So that's 6 attack dice that I get to roll on Drellen. So I'm going to go ahead and give it as big a hit as I got. 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 damage from 6 dice. An incredible roll. But Drellen had 4 defense to start with. So 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Drellen is down to 4 health now. Seems like one more decent swing will take him out. This is getting exciting again. I could do this. The backup plan, I can't benefit from that at this point. The axes, I'm gonna leave them there just in case I need to step and do a, I don't know why I would save them, but at this point I'm not even focusing on hurting those guys, so I'm not doing axes. My turn is over. My turn is over. I could have rolled Intimidate, and I probably should have. That might have cost me. Okay. Here we go. Drellen's up. 2 defense, 2 attack. So he's rolling defense again. And ouch. Poison 2. One defense. Two damage. I have the buff. So the two chips come off. That's it. But that two poison is going to finish me. Unless Patches can do something about it. But Patches will not be able to do something about it. Because next up is the Howler. The Howler is currently on flight. Now, if you recall, Dive puts him next to the weakest available opposing unit, which is now Tantrum. He's available. So he flies over Patches to Tantrum. Howler will roll 3 attack dice, and Tantrum is not quite out yet, actually. He missed. He missed on one. Tantrum is still there. But maybe not for long. We've got more baddies coming. Ah! Okay. So, he's done. Patches is up. He's up. What is Patches going to do? Patches does have stim kit. He has a heal, kind of. He has defense. We can get a heal gear lock going. Definitely rolling defense dice. Has the strongest chance of getting bones. So if he wants to get a heal gear lock, rolling defense helps with that. Patches is, after these, he's all done with the skill dice. He's doing everything he can. Here we go. Now, he doesn't really have a target because none of these really apply. Ouch! We got a negative effect on the number 9, the skull with the 1. We're just going to read up on that really quick. We got buff HP. Trying to find it. Oh, here it is. Tainted mixture. Deal number 2 damage to self. You must use this result and exhaust this die, unless you have a way to re-roll it. There are skill dice that allow you to re-roll these things and prevent tainted mixture backfires. Unfortunately, Patches does not have that. Patches will remove 1. Now, I forgot to get my regen at the start of the turn, so Patches is currently at 4 health now. He did roll 2 defense dice, which actually was very bad. What we wanted was bones to heal the gear lock, and he also rolled a low, low heal with a nutrients die. I'm going to do some math and figure out if I want to keep it. At this point, I just needed 1 more HP to keep Tantrum alive, and I wasn't able to, so I'm saving the nutrients. Saving the nutrients. All right, Patches is done. Next up is Purple. So we've got the Sapper. The Sapper move, he's melee, so he moves 2 positions to the closest, weakest available gear lock, which is now Patches, because Tantrum is cut off. The Sapper has Mischief 2 and Signal 1. So we will signal in a 1-point baddie. Mischief 2 takes away 2 of my active slot dice. 1, 2. My defense went away just like that. Also 3 attack. He rolls 4. Patches has 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Patches goes down. That was a lucky roll from him. But I admit I got a little lucky earlier. Maybe just a little. So each gear lock has been knocked out at this point. This is fun. And because Patches is KO'd, that goes away. Perhaps I should have healed Tantrum now, huh? What do you think? Okay, next up is this Goblin Alarmist. He has Signal 3. I need to shuffle in my level 1 baddies and draw from that pile because the level 1 defeated baddies. I'm drawing so many goblins, and griffins with signal. So I go through a deep stack of chips. I just gotta put these back. Fives, one, they're all shuffled in. So the level one goes right under there. Now, as a reminder to everybody, the win condition is to take down Drellen, not to wipe everything. Once Drellen is down, the baddies will run in fear, and they no longer have a leader, Drellen, with them. So the battle has been won. The mission is to go out and defeat Drellen. All right? So, with that in mind, okay, so signal three, we've just done one of three signals for the alarmist. He rolls one attack and two defense dice. That's brutal. He hits me for two. I realize that I lost my last HP there. This buff die is exhausted when there's no HP left in the prep area. So I'm still sitting on those two. Alarmist, and he does two damage to me, which is overkill, kind of, because, yeah, I only had one HP. So this poison goes away. Now, check it out. Patches managed to unexhaust that die and put a revive right back on me. So I do not get exhausted. I do not get knocked out. It prevents a knockout. It's an instant effect. When I would be knocked out, I remain on the battle mat. I remain my position here, and this is exhausted. So now I keep my stats. But this doesn't really help me now because my dexterity and attack are equal. So the only thing I'm benefiting is from that, which also doesn't really help me at this point. I'm kind of in trouble now. But looks like I've got one more chance. Round five. Here we go. I'm gonna go for it. I've got four dice. I'm rolling four attack dice. It's kind of a bummer that I didn't have additional dexterity to take advantage of that sweet buff that Patrick gave me earlier. By the way, when a Gearlock is KO'd, it's not that all the other buffs go away, they remain. So I'm still benefiting from it, kind of. So we've got four attack dice, and Tantrum will be attacking Drellen, who has 1, 2, 3, 4 HP and one defense on it. So if you're paying attention, I need 1, 2 and no bones from this roll to finish it. Here we go. I did not do it. I have one bone here. I'm going to put that right in there. 1, 2, 3 damage. Drellen takes away his HP, his defense. 1, 2. He's still sitting on 2 HP. That goes up there. All right, this is probably good game. Let's see, but clearly, I was just so very close. In fact, I was supposed to probably get him down to just 1 HP. Drellen's up. Here we go. He's got full roll. 5 dice. He rolls only one attack. Maximizes the poison that I don't have yet. But he rolls 3 defense. So 1 taken away from Tantrum. Drellen's turn is over. Next up is the Howler. Howler has 3, and Tantrum is KO'd. This concludes our fight for Drellen. But, as I said earlier, it's only day 8. So, this afternoon, if the fight occurs during the day, you've got your recovery phase in the evening, afternoon, evening, however you want to envision it. Here's the recovery phase. So I will be going into the recovery phase. I'll be resting and recovering. And then, obviously, I don't have any loot and I'm a little bit worse off than I was before. In day 9, I would still have similar baddies that would come out, 3 fives. On day 10, a 20 would come out and start on the board, so that's a tough one. But I have a choice. I could actually go back to do another encounter for day 9 and try and earn 2 additional training points. And the progress point is not needed, but it's fine. So 2 training points, so I can strengthen myself. And then on day 10, I can go back to Drellen and face him again and see if I have better luck next time. So thank you for joining me. This was a fun fight, actually. They all are, but I love to see how it unfolds. I love to see the relationships between the gear locks, how Patches and Tantrum, they kind of work together. Obviously, being knocked out is a regular part of the game, especially with Patches anyways. Boomer, Pickett have other ways of mitigating damage. Patches' play style is really with the KOs. Thank you very much for joining me.